And now we are going to learn how to find everything here in your Contractor QuickBooks file. The trial balance is the main financial report. It shows the balance of every account in your chart of accounts. It shows the current balance of your bank account. It shows the total of each expense for the whole company, regardless of job. It shows the total of each income account that were billed from the items that were put on the invoice. You can double-click any balance and get the detail of every transaction for that balance. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Notice you don't see anything. The reason you don't see anything is because the trial balance, by default, opens up showing only the results of whatever the previous month is. I am recording this video in July of 2016. My Windows clock says July of 2016. So therefore, the trial balance opens automatically showing everything that happened during June of 2016. But in our little story of this course, everything happened during 2017. The way to make sure the trial balance always includes everything, regardless of date, is to click from the top left corner, the date pull-down choice, scroll all the way up, and click the choice that says All. Now the trial balance is showing the accumulated totals of all transactions, regardless of date. Notice the Cash and Chase Bank balance is $7,000. Notice we have two different income accounts. That's because some of the items that we put on the invoices are connected to this account, income from heating repair, and the other items that are on the that we put on invoices are connected to this account, income from plumbing services. Accounts receivable represents all of the unpaid open invoices at this moment. Now, these are accumulated totals. One of the best things about the trial balance is that it makes it easy to find things if you know which account in your chart of accounts the transaction has been recorded into. So, if I want to see every single transaction that led up to this $7,000 balance in Cash and Chase Bank, I can double-click on the $7,000 and I can see there were three payments that we received during this course. And I can see the date, and I can see whom I received it from. So, this is a detail explaining why the summary or the total is in the trial balance for the balance of cash and bank. If I want to see any of these individual transactions, I could double-click right there, and I could come right back to the window that I recorded that transaction, and I could make any change I want and then save it, and QuickBooks will adjust the results in the report for anything I change in this window. The same is true for the income accounts. What about this income from heating repair? When I double click, I see that the reason the balance of income from heating repair is $9,635, well, that's because of all of these different invoices. Some of them went to Kirschbaum and some of them went to Brown for the different jobs. And of course, you could always make the columns wider or the window wider. But these are the transactions listed in date order. Yes, I have a mistake for invoice number 7. And of course, if I fix the date here, it would show up down there. But the point is that it also shows you the running balance if it were correct. And I could double click on any one of these invoices. And at the moment I see it in front of me, if I need to, I could change any piece of information on this invoice and save it. And as soon as I save the change, the results in this detail would change. And of course, the results in the summary of the trial balance would change. Since the trial balance is such a helpful report, let's pin it up in the icon bar. Everybody click View, Add Trial Balance to the icon bar, and click OK. Now we have a shortcut to the main financial report. Another helpful way of finding things in your file is using the history that every transaction window has. For example, invoice history shows every payment that has been ever applied to that particular invoice. So, for example, if we open up income from heating repairs and we double-click the January 9th invoice to Brown Company, we can see that this invoice is paid in full. Now, if you keep your ribbon open, you have main menu choices that lead you to different ribbon choices. Choose the Reports tab in the ribbon and then go to Transaction History. When I click Transaction History, when this particular invoice is open, I can see a window that shows me every payment that has been applied to this particular invoice. And it shows the running balance of the invoice. The invoice was originally $1,350, and that was back on January 9th. Then on January 20th, we applied $1,000, and the balance of the invoice went down to $350. Then on January 23rd, we applied another $350, and the balance of this invoice became zero. If I want to see payment from check number 61, I can click on it and then click Go To, and the payment itself will open up and I can see what's going on and even adjust or change anything. And if I change something, when I save it, the results in the reports will fix immediately. Another helpful thing about the history feature is that estimate history shows every invoice that has been made for that estimate. To see every estimate in the file, open up the Estimate by Job report. Now, let's say, for example, the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. We'll choose this estimate for January 2nd, estimate number 2. When we double-click, we see that the ribbon is already open, and we choose the Reports tab in the ribbon to find transaction history. Notice this particular estimate number 2 has been billed by invoice number 3, has been billed by invoice number 4, and if you scroll down, has been billed by invoice number 5. Unfortunately, you do have to scroll up and down to make sure that you found every invoice applied to this estimate. What's good about this window is it shows the running balance of the estimate at a particular moment in time. Unfortunately, it will not consider the change orders. It will only consider the invoices. For example, January 2, the balance of the estimate was $67.50. That was the unbilled amount. Then as of January 9, because January 9 we billed them with invoice number 3, the balance of the unbilled amount went down to $5,400. January 14, we billed them again with invoice number 4, and the balance went down to $2,700. And when we come down here, we see that on January 17th, we sent them invoice number 5 against this particular estimate. And now the unbilled balance of this estimate is $1,350. We can always click the Go To button, and we will go to whatever invoice is selected. And this is the invoice we made on January 17th. To see if any payments were applied to this invoice, we can click the invoice transaction history, and it says, sorry, no payments have been applied to this invoice. You should know that in QuickBooks, there are other transactions in QuickBooks that are linked to other transactions. History always shows the related transaction. For example, if you were using the undeposited feature and then you made deposits, you could look at the history of deposits to see every payment that was included in that deposit. So whenever one transaction follows from another, the history window will always show the related transactions. You should watch the bonus videos about the Find Window, the Search Bar, the Journal Report, and the Audit Trail. These are four things in QuickBooks that if you're comfortable using them, and they're very easy, you will never be lost. You will always be able to find anything you're looking for by using what I showed you in this video or one of these four tools. The Advanced Find will help you find all the estimates in the file, even though estimates are not transactions. You can view the transaction list by customer report, and that would be another way to see all the estimates. Of course, if you use this report, that means that you're seeing everything in a list for that customer, including the estimates. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Reports, Customers and Receivables, Transaction List by Customer. Make sure the date pull-down says A for all. So, for example, under Brown Company, here's every estimate and invoice for the Hanson Place job. Look at the Mockingbird Lane job under Brown Company. It has the estimate, then the invoice, then the payments. Same thing for the Kirschbaum job on Southwoods Road. We have the invoices, the estimates, and payments aligned in date order. Unfortunately, it does not give you the running balance, but it will show you the estimates included in the list with invoices and payments. If you saw the video on the search tool, you know that you can use the search tool to find change orders. The search tool is pretty much the only thing in QuickBooks that will help you find change orders, or help you specifically find change orders, because they're not separate documents, they will not show up in the journal, they will not show up in the Find window, and they will not show up on any specific report. So you have to use the search tool to find all of them. The search tool will look through the entire file and try and find the text that you type into the search bar in the icon bar. Type in change order. It's not case sensitive. So after we type in change order and hit enter, we will see every instance of the word change order in the file. Notice on the estimate for Kirschbaum, there's the word change order, and we could always click open and see the estimate that has the change order. And when we scroll all the way down, we can see the change order is listed here at the bottom of the estimate. Also notice that the same change order shows up on the invoice that relates to that estimate. If we click open and we open this invoice where the history shows that it's related to the that estimate, we can scroll down and we can see the change order that relates to that particular invoice, because that invoice relates to that estimate. This is simply because we put the word change order here, and it has the word change order in the file list because I named one of the files change orders. So the search bar is very helpful if you're looking for any kind of text that's written in any transaction or any of the list items in QuickBooks.